The National Gallery of Senegal is a fitting venue for the last stop on the tour. The gallery offers plenty of space in which the paintings have room to be seen at their best. Dakar is a crossroad of the ancient and the thoroughly modern, a meeting place of European, Muslim, and Black African culture.
One of the things that sort of come out in the trip is same kind of experience I had when I was living in New York, where you'd get to these moments of feeling sorry for yourself, and you'd walk down the street and see somebody that you just feel like an asshole feeling sorry for yourself, you know, because people here are just doing amazing things with little resources. And so you feel pretty spoiled. You feel pretty decadent.
At the Ifam Gallery in Dakar is one of the most remarkable collections of modern art anywhere, assembled by collector and artist Mortala Diop.
His name is Ousmane Sow.
He's Senegalese.
He's Senegalese. He's one of our best artists, and he's gone to the Biennale, La Biennale de Venise this weekend, and he's about maybe 55 years old, and he used to be Paris. And from there, that's where he get his work from, and to feel the muscles and the bodies. And he's doing it like each group of people, tribe he does 12 pieces or 7 pieces.
The quality of an artist's work is rarely reflected by their material circumstances. One such artist is Papisto Boy, whose work is devoted to increasing social consciousness. Over a period of 5 years, he has painted more than 600 meters of murals on the walls of the industry which now surround his fishing village.
Je l'ai pris presque au bord de la mer parce que je suis grandi avec les pêcheurs ici et c'est la mer qui m'a inspiré. Parce que bon, c'est quelque chose qui mène un développement de l'environnement. Et je souhaite aussi que les gens viennent ici apprécier les dessins pour savoir beaucoup de choses, pour leur ouvrir les yeux et leur faire connaître aussi que la peinture, c'est comme de la littérature. C'est comme si on lisait un bouquin, un livre ou un roman.
Claudine is surprised to encounter an artist who shares her own vision of public art as a vehicle of social change. She hopes he will be accepted by the larger group of artists to work with them on a major mural now being planned in Dakar.
Senegal, Senegal.
The Blaise Senghor Community Center in Dakar is chosen as a site for the final and most ambitious mural of the tour.
This is nice. I like this.
I was thinking in Dakar's daily life related with our spirit from Dakar.
One of the problems I had with the other murals, and they were fine, is that because people were mixing up stuff so fast, that certain elements didn't get time to be realized. So that the people who work in a faster, perhaps more expressive or explosive style would predominate because they're so quickly throwing in their thing. Whereas I like to build up a lot of form, and I never had a chance to realize that anywhere else.
Claudine chooses a spot in the shade working near Papisto Boy, who is already well along with his section. The community center is used for all kinds of artistic activities, including theater and dance. By mid-afternoon, the temperature hovers near 40 degrees. Papisto Boy easily holds his own among some well-known Senegalese painters. Despite the heat, the group Sinemu continue with their daily rehearsal, preparing for a performance of a modern dance written by Mamadou Konate.
Of people going to make art as a part of their daily life. Just to recover that sense of making art as a part of my daily way of living, and loving, and looking people and humanity.
I don't know if art changes society, if we can show that we were there. The very fact that we were working together and the nature of how we were working together and the way we presented ourselves working together has an effect. And the fact that we're here doing it is a healthy sign in the first place.
Sugar, my dog.